Labor Day tomorrow. No fun? You want to go to Richland Center today?
Oh.
I don't want
to. Dad, I made him a beard.
It's Daddy Day.
I made him a beard. I made him a beard.
You made him a beard? Show Michelle.
I made Fly Guy a beard. I'm homeschooled.
Oh, yeah. My mom was a teacher.
Go
save that one.
But it can't fly. It can't fly.
No wings? Yeah, I'm like Mr. Beast Jr.
Your friend has more than that. He's only got 50 more.
Church.
You guys aren't laboring. So, just a couple
of DT is a DJ.
Real quickly, we have some of these binders and that someone brought in for us. And we have 3-inch binders,
DT.
The 2-inches, 1-inch. If anybody wants them, they're back there for school, whatever you might need. So, please. Come and take if you would like. We have other announcements coming after church, so we just want everybody to come and relax a little bit today. Let the Lord come into your hearts. Sometimes we need just to make God in control. Let him kind of form us the way we need to be shaped, not the way we want. Let's just take a few minutes. All those here, all the London way in back. Let's just relax and come to God today and let him be with us. Let us pray. God's ways.
We come to be guided in the ways of God's truth, to experience the joy of God's salvation.
We come aware of God's steadfast love, helping us to overcome the trials and tribulations which can descend upon us at any time.
Lead us, O God, to do what is right in your eyes, and teach us to follow the humble ways of Jesus our Lord.
The Lord is our Lord, and how majestic is his name. Let us turn to the hymnal 121. Let us stand and let us sing. Holy Father, you hear us. Holy Father, you know us. Father, we are so sorry for the sins we have committed. But Father, we ask you to shape us and to mold us in your way, so that we might turn away from evil and yet, Father, come to you. This day and every day, when we're truly sorry for the sins we have committed, in Jesus' name, those sins are forgiven. Well, if you turn in your Bibles to Jeremiah, shape us in the way you want us to live. In your gracious name, Father. Amen. Jeremiah 18, verse 1. The Lord came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Come and go down to the potter's house, and there I will let you hear my words. So I went down to the potter's house, and there he was working at his wheel. The vessel he was making of clay was spoiled in the potter's hand, and he reworked it into another vessel, as it seems good to him. Then the word of the Lord came to me. Can I not do with you, O house of Israel, just as this potter has done, says the Lord? Just like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. At this one moment, I made a prayer concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will pluck up, break down, and destroy it. But if the nation concerning which I have spoken turns from evil, I will change my mind about the disaster and I intended to bring upon it. And in another moment, I may declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will build up and plant it. But if it does evil in my sight, not listening to my voice, then I will change my mind about the good that I have intended to do with it. Now therefore, says the people of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, thus says the Lord, look, I am the potter shaping evil against you and debasing a plain against you. Turn now, all of you, from the evil ways and amend your ways you are doing. And amend your ways and your doings. Amend them. Change them. The Lord has given us a good measure. He has given us so much. And yet, for some odd reason, what do we do? We decide that he hasn't done it good enough. So we decide the way our lives should be, instead of the way God wants our lives to be. Now, he shapes us and he molds us and he makes us who we are, and yet we know better than God, don't we? Oh, he doesn't mind if I really do this. Oh, it's just my favorite. It was just a little sin. It won't hurt others too much. No. A sin is a sin. The truth is the truth. Now, is it easy to do? No. Is it easy to follow God's ways? It should be, and it seems like it. But no. All of us have a little problems with it. We kind of want to do it our way. I did it my way. Okay. A lot of who's out there. But why don't we do it God's way? Let him shape us and form us. It's not necessarily the easy way or the way we want it, but it's best because he shapes us. Hey, have you ever done any pottery? Who's worked on one of those potter wheels and fixed it? Anybody in here? Yeah, I tried one time in college, and oh my gosh, you wouldn't believe what I made. I had to tell people what I made. It was an absolute disaster, and yet I saw others that knew how to mold it and to shape it, and the more they did it, the better they got. The more they listened to the potter, the instructor, the better and better they had this gift of making different vessels, and they can make bowls, they can make plates, they can make almost anything, and the more they did it, the better they got. And that's what we are. The more we let God shape us, the more we practice what God tells us, the better we get at it. Then it becomes God's way, not our way. And then we start following what He wants us to do, not the way we want things to do. Now listen to what it says in Scripture. It says, "And another moment I declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will build up and plant it. But if it does evil in my sight, not listening to my way, I will destroy it." He will build us up, but He can tear us down. And someone that Pastor Steve, I've done so much terrible things, God can't forgive me. Oh yeah, He can. He says even evil nations, if they come to Him and change their ways and let Him form them, He will bring blessings. But a nation that does His ways and He forms them the way that they want, but they don't follow Him, He will bring destruction. How are we doing as a nation? Are we following God's ways? Jesus Christ's ways? Are we turning against His ways? Are we turning against what Jesus Christ wants us to do in the Father? For some reason, we decide that we can mold things better than God, and we can't. Let Him be the potter and us the clay. Let Him form us the way we need to be formed. And stop listening to us and start listening to the Father. Start listening to Jesus Christ. Stop doing it the way we want. Now, I stopped being a potter because the way I was molding the clay. Was it fun?
Yeah.
And just like so many, when you start doing evil and you're out partying and having a good time, it seems good at the time. But it starts decreasing more and more. And then your life isn't the way you want it to be. I've seen that over and over again. People decide their own way of life. And then when destruction and stuff come, they start blaming others, and then stop, they don't even turn to God. That's right. They don't turn to God. They still are trying to shape themselves. Rather than stepping back, saying, "Lord, I am so sorry for what I have done." And we come to Him. We ask Him to forgive us of our sin, and let Him be the potter. Let Him form us in His ways and not ours. Listen up, people. That's what He's saying. Listen up. Start following His ways and let Him be the potter in forming us. Amen? What?
Amen. Amen.
Well, let's turn to Him 591. Ready? Let us stand. Let thy foot away, Lord.
outside.
Father, you hear our prayers. We ask you to guide us and to lead us and to mold us. Father, we are in your hands. But Father, we come to you and we ask for prayers for Tim and Donna Sullivan's grandson, Paul. We continue to ask you to put your healing hand upon Corky and Mike Thompson, Father. We ask you to be with Bob and Peggy Dan. Continue to put your healing hand upon him. And Tiffany's grandfather, Father, reach out to him and bless him. We ask you to be with Deb Rose's sister, Father Mel. Continue to bless her and be with her. And Lisa Bates' brother, Father. We ask you to continue to be with Donna Smith's daughter, Carrie. Father, we thank you for Richard and Billy Chatterton and all that they have done in their lives. And we ask you to bless them and be with them. But Father, we come to you and we ask in your name, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
let us not hold back from him. And let us do it in joy and thanksgiving. Okay? So many. You can smile when you give an offering. When you got it, you smile. And when you give away, you don't. Let's give back to God who's given us.
Thank you.
We know everything. We know better. We're not going to do that. We're not going to believe in this. We're not going to do this. What do they know? Isn't it funny when they get to be 50 years later? We find out that what? We don't know everything. Oh, it's totally amazing, isn't it? My prayer is that all of those who have gone back to school, college the first time, that they find their way in Christ. They start doing it His way. Let God form them and mold them. Let's pray for all of those. Last couple of weeks they've gone back, and there are so many that have died of different things they have tried because they knew better. They're leaving and not returning. I kind of feel sad at this time of the year for so many that they know better than God. Keep them in your prayers this week. Across the United States, there's been influx of people in death because they knew better. And they keep saying, yeah, we should have known better. Yeah, we all did. All of us. Come to God. Let Him mold us and lead us. Father, this day and every day, You are the potter of me. Father, we are the clay. Let You lead us. And our lives turn out like we would not believe. In Your gracious and holy name, Father, may You be blessed this day in Jesus Christ and in the Father, and let the Holy Spirit lead us in all that we do and say. Amen. I have a few announcements. Ladies Retreat is coming up. There's a little flyer back there. And today is the last sign-up day. Actually, it says tomorrow, but I don't know who will be here tomorrow. So if you've got any questions, please ask Ms. Carla. She'll be glad to guide you and lead you. She's a potter. It really sounds like an incredible program, everyone. It really, really does. We have another announcement. Oh, hi, Tammy. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Tammy. They have been married 69 years. blessing for Richard. Oh, and Billy. But they have wonderful children, they have wonderful grandchildren. Any beyond that? Great-grandkids? Great-grandkids? Great-great-grandkids? Great-great-great-great-grandkids? Billy's going to shoot me. I thought it was important. I know they probably didn't want us to announce, but I think God has blessed you both for 69 years, and that is a blessing. May our Lord and Savior be with you and Richard and your family this day, and all who come to Christ in marriage. May those marriages be blessed this day and every day. Whether it's a couple months or years, Father, bless us and guide us, and let our marriages be a blessing to those that come to know Jesus Christ. Amen. Any other further announcements? Any? Hi, Nick.
Hi, Pastor.
Talk.
We have a birthday tomorrow.
Oh. 69 years?
19.
How many?
Nine.
All I have to say to you, buddy, is happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you. Any other? Any other? Happy anniversary, Jim. Blessings to both of you. Tomorrow is his birthday? Yes. Oh, and Richard, Billy, we're married a few years. Well, think about it. You'll be 9 years old, right? And that's only 60 years before you were born. Birthdays and anniversaries are a blessing. Every birthday God gives you is a blessing. Don't pull back. Let them know. My mom was an orphan. And she said, God bless me with a birthday. And when someone asks me how old I am, God gave me those years, I tell them. That I was 35 for twice. It is a blessing. Bless you all today and every day. May go and have fellowship today, but on the roads, please be careful. May our Lord and Savior bless you again. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Go with God.
Just hit her.